Coach Okir here, and this is Boruto Episode 16 Review. Okay, so in terms of pacing, this episode was pretty nice. It was its own thing, which I think is nice. It's not part of the series, it's its own story. And some people don't like that, some people do. I personally like that. That aside, let's talk about what happened. We find out the obvious, that Lee Metal was Rock Lee's son. Honestly, when I was first introduced to Lee Metal, I thought it was kind of a Rock Lee-Mike Guy relationship, where it's not that he was a son, but he was someone who was struggling because he was only good at taijutsu. But I was wrong, and later on in the story, there were a few teasers that were giving it away that Rock Lee was his father, and I kind of figured it that way. That aside, the main focus of this chapter was Iwabe and Denki. Denki. And basically, what happens here is this episode focuses on them passing the exam, the graduation exam, which they both do, which in turn means that they are going to be in the same class as Boruto and Sarada and Mitsuki and Shikadai and Chocho and so on and so forth. Which is good. Some people were actually afraid of that because they thought that meant that there's going to be a plot hole in terms of why weren't they in the Boruto movie. And I honestly don't think that's a plot hole because you don't get to see your friends every single day, and the Boruto movie takes place in just like a few days. So I honestly don't think it's that big of a deal. Some people do. If you think so, that's okay. It's just my perspective, you know. That aside, in terms of characterization, we get some characterization in terms of both Iwabe and Denki, because they both show that they really care about one another and that they are willing to put time aside so they could help one another. And that's shown when Iwabe helped Denki with his ninjutsu, the tree climbing jutsu, I think, way back when in the beginning of Naruto, and Denki helped Iwabe in terms of studying, but you know, the wire technology and all that sort of stuff. I don't know why you need to know that if you're going to graduate from the Ninja Academy, but whatever. And speaking of the Ninja Academy, it seems like they reformed their educational system and added some new stuff, because if you remember, the tree climbing jutsu was not mandatory in the last graduation exam that we saw in the original Naruto series. So it seems like that was added on later after the war or after the time skip. And that just means that the quality of ninja is supposed to be higher or the same and didn't decrease, which doesn't make sense because conflict is going down right now. Therefore, the quality of ninja is also supposed to be going down. Just for me, it doesn't make sense, but whatever, I'm going with it. It's not that big of a deal. So in this episode, Iwabe and Denki save a few kids, and that's all nice, you know, the heroism and stuff, and you get to see a few action scenes. Iwabe using the mud wall jutsu, and Iwabe and Denki climbing up to save the kids. Besides that, it was a nice episode because it had a few little gags. You know, Boruto thinking that he fucked up everything, and that moment where he gives them the hot burgers. I thought that was funny. You know. Personally, in terms of rating, I'd give this a 3 out of 5. It wasn't that good, it wasn't that bad. I mean, 3 out of 5 in my perspective isn't bad, it's just 4 out of 5. 5 out of 5 is like up there, but this episode wasn't up there, but it was a nice episode. And not every episode is going to be a 5 out of 5 or a 4 out of 5, so I think it was a nice episode. I just didn't think it was like, you know, it was like, whoa. Yeah. But, you know, that's my perspective. And I'd like to hear your views down in the comments below. And if you like what I had to say, please subscribe. If you didn't, please explain why. And I would hope you guys like my content later on. This is Moshuk here, and I'm out.